Well, we are actually in the faculty core facilities of the Faculty of Medicine here in the sixth floor. I mean, it's a silverfish core facility where we actually provide services in terms of expertise and animal husbandry to people who are interested in making use of silverfish in their respective research. The reason why they were called silverfish, as you can see, that basically because of the blue stripes that run across the body, that they look like zebra. And that's why we call it silverfish. And these are the adult silverfish that we are keeping in the aquarium in here. And each of these little tanks, in fact, they are housing silverfish of a particular genotype because we basically engineer them to express specific genes, or sometimes the genes could be removed genetically, I mean, based on the genetic engineering, so that they can develop diseases pretty much like human leukemia. People actually make use of silverfish as a model of human diseases because it produces lots of eggs. If you want to repeat your experiment, it's very easy. And because now that we know that the genome of the silverfish is very much similar to higher vertebrates, including mouse and human, and more than 80% of the genes that are expressed in human are shared by the silverfish. So it's a remarkably interesting experimental model. And also, as a model organism, the embryos produced by the silverfish, the little small embryos, basically it's very amenable to genetic manipulation. We can actually put in leukemic genes to make them become leukemic, or we can delete certain genes that make them become defective, having a defective blood systems. And you can see through them with a very simple dissecting microscope. And it developed incredibly rapidly from a one cell stage to the time when you can actually see a beating heart. It takes less than 24 hours. So, I mean, therefore, that whatever things you do to the silverfish embryos, you can very rapidly see them within 1 or 2 days. Well, in each of the tanks, we basically can house like 10 to 20 of them. So you can imagine that you can basically, we are housing like thousands of silverfish, adult silverfish, in this little small aquarium. I mean, if you were to do experiment on mouse, you can't possibly do it. You need to have a much, much, much bigger facility to house equal number of mouse. Did I talk to them?
Yeah.
Unfortunately, well, I mean, the hearing system of the silverfish, put it this way, are actually much worked out. I mean, in terms of the neurons, in terms of the reception or the hearing of the fish, the process are very much conserved. I've not tried talking to the fish, but I'm sure they can hear.